Yo, what's going on, guys, and welcome back to another video. And in today's video, we're going to be counting down the top 5 worst injuries in NHL history. And before I get into this one, I want to say that some of these are kind of gory, so don't watch them if you don't like seeing a bit of blood. So with that being said, in a February 10th, 2008 game between the Florida Panthers and Buffalo Sabres, Ole Jokinen was knocked down by Clark MacArthur, and as he fell to ice, his skate came up and cut teammate Richard Zanuck's throat, cutting his carotid artery and just missing his jugular vein. Zednik was rushed to the hospital and required an hour of surgery to reconnect the artery. Zednik missed the remainder of the season, but returned to Florida Panthers for his final season in 2008 and 2009, but eventually fully recovered from this injury. I actually couldn't find a clip of this injury because it happened so long ago, so I'm just going to show you some pictures and give you a bit of a backstory on it. So on January 15th, 1968, as a member of the Minnesota North Stars, Bill Masterton took a hit from Oakland Seals defenseman Larry Cahan and Ron Harris and fell backwards, landing on his head and knocking him unconscious. Masterton allegedly regained consciousness long enough to mutter the words, "Never again, never again," before again losing consciousness. He passed away due to his injuries 30 hours after the hit and is the only player in the NHL history to die as a direct result from on-ice injuries. Masterton has had his name immortalized by the NHL with a trophy bearing his name, given out annually for perseverance, sportsmanship, and dedication to hockey. Now again, this one is probably one of the toughest ones to watch on here, so if you guys do not like blood, make sure to just look away and not watch this and skip on to the next one. So 19 years before Zednik had his throat slashed, on March 22, 1989, while playing net for the Buffalo Sabres, Clint Malarchuk took a skate to the throat from St. Louis Blues Steve Tuttle. Tuttle and Krupp had gotten tangled up in front of the net and fell on top of the goaltender. Tuttle's skate cut Malarchuk's jugular vein and severed his carotid artery. Sabres trainer Jim Pizzutoli rushed to Malarchuk's aid and put pressure on his neck to stabilize the injury and save his life. After being rushed to the hospital for surgery, Malarchuk remarkably returned to the ice just 10 days later. In Clint Malarchuk's autobiography, he reveals that this is one of few incidents in which he escaped death. Later, he put a bullet in his brain and survived, having dealt with depression, obsessive-compulsive disorder, and post-traumatic stress disorder, the latter of which resulted from his injury. This is one of the most controversial things to ever happen in the NHL. I'm sure a lot of you have already heard of this. I think we all remember the night Steve Moore's career was ended 8:41 into the third period of a 9-2 Colorado Avalanche victory over the Vancouver Canucks on February 16, 2004. Allegedly looking for retribution for a hit on Canucks captain Marcus Naslin, Todd Bertuzzi grabbed Moore from behind, sucker punched him, and drove him into the ice. Two more players jumped on top, and after lying motionless on the ice for 10 minutes, Steve Moore was stretchered off the ice. Moore suffered 3 broken vertebrae and a concussion, and never played another game. Bertuzzi was suspended for the incident, pleaded guilty to criminal assault causing bodily harm, and in the summer of 2014, more than 10 years after the incident, the two sides reached an agreement on a civil suit. Now I chose this one for number 1 because I was actually watching this game live. Obviously it's not the worst of all the injuries, obviously the worst is Bill Masterson passing away from his injury, but I chose this number 1 because I kind of seen it live and that makes me remember it more vividly. So in a March 8th game, 2011, between the Boston Bruins and Montreal Canadiens, Zdeno Chara threw a check on Max Pacioretty that forced him to collide face first with the stanchion at the end of the Bruins bench. Pacioretty was knocked unconscious and suffered a severe concussion along with a fractured vertebrae. He was sidelined for the remainder of the 2011-2012 season. Ridiculously, the Montreal police felt the need to investigate Chara for the incident, but no charges were laid. Perhaps equally as ridiculous, Mark Recchi claimed that a trip to the movie theater by Pacioretty a few days after the injury was proof that he wasn't seriously injured. Thank you for your diagnosis. Like, that's kind of ridiculous, but yeah, so actually just glad that Max Pacioretty's okay and nothing really serious came out of this injury. So that's going to do it for this video, guys. Again, if you didn't see my last video, check it out, my giveaway, and enter that if you haven't entered it already for 500 subscribers. Again, thank you guys for 500 subscribers. All the support has been great, and let's try to get 10 likes on this video. I hope you guys enjoyed, and make sure to subscribe for more videos like this, and I'll see you guys in the next one.